I mostly use my name only because I remember this only. And you have remembered that mid formula. In mid formula, what we do that we take reference of text and choose where to start from. Starting number would be that from one. And how many characters I need there? I need one. So it will return me the first character. Now I just fix this value and drag this here. So here when I change the position to here and 3 here, so I'm changing only the starting number. So this thing I can do through array formula. Okay, what will I do? There is a 7 characters in my name, so I will choose the 7 cells here. Then mid formula text sequence would be this one, and the starting number I can choose through column 1, 2, 7. Or in curly braces, I can provide 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. And number of characters I require 1, and then Control Shift Enter. So if I change the value, this will also change. Where can I use this thing?
We can put to only 7, or we can put 100 also, doesn't matter.
Yes, doesn't matter.
We can do it that way, even though letters are less.
Yes, we can put n numbers. So when you have some forms like government forms, like things, or account number, there they require n block letters. The name and father's name in block letter. So if you design the format in Excel, it is difficult to enter those values in single cell. So you can design a formula for that. That is, I have written here. So you just put your name here and it will show you the result. But I provide this one. Okay. So maximum of characters I have chosen here. Suppose I here choose some 30, 40. This type. So I can choose lot of cells here and type n numbers here, Control Shift Enter. Now what I'll do, Kumar Singh, in one go I will put the name and it will be distributed like this. So it is easy to put text in a single cell. So you can refer to this formula for doing all the things. So if I show you some sheet which I have made for my previous company, the same format I have designed through mid formula.
Okay, one time you showed me this one actually,
Yes, RTGS NEFT application. So I have done all the things through mid formula only. When you go in data form, so I have taken cell references of this one. Okay, sir. So this is easy and powerful thing which you can use. Now let's make some dynamic changes here. such as I want to put only those values dynamically. If my name contains 7 digit, it should fix here 7 only, 1 to 7 only. If it is 10, so it should display 1 to 10 only. So first we need to understand that column function, what is doing here. As we have seen in our when we have evaluated this formula, it will never show here because for this cell it is processing single digit only. But if you put some formula, any of the other formula in which it hides something and then you evaluate it, then the full evaluation will be shown here. 1 to 60, the values, rest of the things are blank, and then evaluate. So you can see the functionality of that. So yeah. I want this thing to be dynamic. So basically it is an address. 1 to 60 means columns. Here you can see a green area. Means 1 to 60 column has been selected. So
yeah,
if it is an address, so we have a formula for converting text to address. So what we will do here, we will do in column, I will put it to inverted comma, and I have an indirect function for converting text into range. So I will put and here, and instead of 60 I'll choose the length of the text. Okay, where it gone? Yeah. And I need number of characters. I need to cross the bracket and then control shift enter. Now the range is dynamic. Okay, whether I put small ranges, whether I put long, it will change his address according to it. But here you will find no changes here. Where we need that, where we have some less space, suppose we have this much of space and the values are lot of, we have to work in this 7 or 10 cells, there we use it. Okay, sir. Next. Suppose I have some values here, range and between 10 to 90. And in this figure, I want to sum largest 5. So for large 5, top 5 or bottom 5 values, if I want to sum, then how we will do that? I will put here a large formula, choose the array, fix it, and then k means the position. It is the first largest value, and then I drag this. Is taking reference of this one, first largest, second largest, third largest, fourth largest, fifth largest, and then total. This is the total, but I don't want to do all these things here. I need only top five values. How will I do this? I will put some formula and in large I will choose range here, and in K this thing is needed. Either I can use this column formula or I can put the values in 1, 2, 3.
Why use that different bracket?
Yes.
That is array, okay.
This thing you can use and close the sum, then control shift enter. Same result you will find here. But when you need small five, you can use a small formula. Rest of all the will be same.
Have I used internally like 1, 2, 6 as a different the brackets?
Because let me show you why.
Yeah.
I have chosen. You just evaluate formula, then you understand what. That small formula, I just make it large. Then control shift enter. When we evaluate this formula, we can see the large formula, because the K takes only one position. Okay, when we evaluate what it has done, the large formula returns multiple of it results. According to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it has returned this.
Yeah, if you put the normal small brackets, it will not, not work, right?
Yes.
Because that is array. Okay.
So multi-cell processing, for multi-cell value processing, it is returning like this. When we sum it, it gives us with the result.
Yeah.
Basically, this is the processing. Then here I have some minus values, negative values in this. But I want that the negative values should also be summed like plus values. You know the ABS formula? That can that can convert negative into positive. Okay, so the all the negative values are positive now, and now I can take total of that. Now through array, how I will do that? I'll sum ABS, and ABS takes only one cell reference. I can put whole range here and then control shift enter. Control shift enter. The same result is here. So these are very powerful formula which you can use according to your need.
It's true.
Now we will let you know that how to deal with conditions in it. Okay, so here I have some values. Now what I want to do, that the value which are greater than 50, values which are greater than 50, where there is true, these values to be summed only. If I put, how I will put that, I'll put sum if range comma criteria, what is the criteria is true, and then some range I choose this. So this value I needed greater than 50. Then how will I do that? I can put some if formula, basically a combination of some and if formula. So I put some formula, and in if formula I put a condition that whether this range is greater than 50 or not. See, in logical test we just usually choose a one cell reference, but here I have chosen all the cells, all the range. So this is also an array.
Okay.
If you select this one and press F9, it will produce the same result. You can see there, with curly braces, with semicolon.
Yeah.
So you can see here, now I choose the range again, which are greater than 50. In case of true, what should be there? The value. For the value I also choose the range, whole range. But where there is no value, it should produce zero. Okay. Then close. Then we will put Control Shift Enter. So there is same result. We will go to evaluate formula. What happened? It is evaluated the range in true false. Okay. Where there is true will be converted as the actual range, the range value. Otherwise it would be zero. So you can see where there was no zero, no true, there was false, so there you can find zero. Rest of the values are pasted here. Okay.
Yeah.
Then we evaluate that 692. So I feel that somewhere you understand the concept of why I am doing. What is
error? Yeah, I got the concept. Yes. Only thing is where we need to use it, how effectively and efficiently we can use it, that is important.
Yes, sir. Yes. Now, we can use a lot of more things here. Let's see. Our website Tech on the Net. And there we can go to Excel and array formula. Criteria value. You see the first example of that. Let's make the same data here, 8, 6, 12, 7, and 10. Next there is 150, 180, 200, 150, and 100. Then you have
U B.
U.
Oh, no.
जी, इन दिस फॉर्मूला व्हाट दे हैव डन, दिस फॉर्मूला ए फाइव टू ए वन टू ए फाइव देन मल्टीप्लाई बाय बी वन टू बी फाइव इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सी वन टू सी फाइव इज इक्वल टू यू. What they have done actually. Sum. This one. To be multiplied with this range equal to 150. Then they have multiplied this one to this one equal to u. So put this one in bracket. Then control shift enter. The result is 15. What is that actually? The condition is where there is 150 and where there is u, only that cell should be summed. Okay, sir. These two cells, but
yeah.
How they have identified in this formula? Firstly, they have taken a simple range, okay, then multiplied with this logical condition. In logical condition, if you evaluate, you will find true and false only. If we press F9, what we will find, there is true false, and true means what? 1. False means what? 0.
Yeah.
Okay. So when you multiply something, 8 in 1 will be 8, and 8 in 0 will be 0. So 6 equal to 0 will be, if we multiply both of them, what would happen? We can see from here. I just select this one. To this one and press F9. What happened there? Where there was a false, it was 0 there. Where there was true, the value remained there. So 8, 7 remained there. Okay.
Yeah.
Next, if we multiply this value into this true false, what would happen? Where there is true, it will be 1. Okay. When we multiplied 8 into 1 and 7 into 1, then it is okay. It is based upon u calculation, where there is a u. So we find that there are two values, and we will find the sum here. This is the result. Okay. Now you understand what happened in this.
Yeah.
Okay. So basically, we have put two conditions like sum is, where there is value.
Yes. Yeah.
150. Or where there is u.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have applied sum is here through array function. Now see, sometimes we need to put two criteria. Here what they are going to do, AB 5 to 15, AB 5 to 15, yani with this cell, multiplied by e5 to e30 equal to 2. So this one and this one, where there is 2, it will be highlighted, it will return true. In this it will be multiplied by this, we will find 14.2 and 2.3 only. Then they are saying there are two conditions exactly. AB5, AB13 should be greater than 0. Means there are two also here. Here you also find true, but should be greater than 0. So this one is not greater than 0. So here 0 will it multiply, so it will be 0 here. So these two values will remain, and the total of this one, because we have chosen this one of range for total. Okay, understand, sir?
Yeah.
Now see some more formulas. We need to actually practice from here only. You can choose. You have a lot of examples here. What they are doing? Client ID, client name, total spent for product. Pull some from other sheet, $100. Okay, product A order, $100. Yeah. What they are doing? Okay, without VLOOKUP formula, they have done something here. It was just like VLOOKUP formula. Use an array formula to sum all of the order values for a given client. For a single client, they were calculating the total order value, such as client B, the total value will be calculated there. So it is like sum if, so what's difficult in that? ABCD, the all clients, the total values. So it is not difficult, I think, that multiply, they have multiplied the same thing, nothing was there.
Some ifs you can use it, I think, yeah.
Yes, yes. It is only worth there. Okay, sir. I think you should take time for practice.
Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. So, we will move tomorrow in or something. Means, because it requires practice.
And sure.
Then we will move on. Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
And actually, I'm tired also.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much. Bye.